we're gonna make something tonight for Din Din. How about that? And it's called Grillades. Looks like it's when you look at the word Grillades, it looks like it's spelled Grillades. We ain't got no AIDS. And we ain't gonna grill it. It's Grillades. It can be served with grits, rice, potatoes, whatever the hell you want. We're gonna do it with some Miss JB's smothered potatoes. And I'll do the best I can with them. She does them better, but I'll be able to deal with it. The first thing we gotta do is get us some flour in some kind of container. You could do it in a Ziploc. I'm getting low, so I'm gonna hold off on that. And we're gonna put some Cajun seasoning in there. And that was just self-rising flour, and it's got some salt in that, so be careful, don't put too much. I got some round steak right here. This is bottom round. It was on sale, so that's what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna defat most of it. Could look here. See, it got some marbling in that meat. But we're gonna cut the big strips of fat off and kind of cut this in little strips or cubes or wherever my knife wants to go. Hopefully it don't go into my finger, because I'd be pissed off to the highest level of pissedivity. So let me get them steaks wrenched and putting this seasoned flour. We're gonna mix up. May need a little more flour in there, JB. What you think? Sounds like it does. And then we go from here, because we got other stuff to do. All this got to go in there, too. The wine bottle ain't showing, but you know some wine going in there. Okay, so we cut them up into little strips and pieces and parts, and I added a little bit more pepper and a little bit more flour in there. And we're going to go ahead and worry this in there. Okay? I'm going to give them a little light coating of flour. You can do this without the flour if you so want to. So coat them down with flour, seasoned flour, and we're going to go fry them off in some oil. Is this gluten-free? Probably not. Do I care? Probably not. We get into that later if we gotta have all that shit. So, shake off the excess. Get off of there, boy. And you go fry these little strips down. Look, my hand looks like a ghost. Boo! Hope that stupid ass camera boy was recording. I'll put these in there and watch your temperature. See, the oil ain't hot enough yet. So we'll go ahead and get a couple more of these ready while it all heating up. Gotta shake the flour off of like I told you, boy. Shake, shake. There, now you're all up to temp. And I got it on a smaller burner. See? So I can control the heat a little better in that big ass pan. Don't lick your fingers. Don't scratch your private parts. Wash your hands in the damn sink. Boy! Oh yeah, that fat you trimmed off, you can cook that in the nuke and give it to your dogs, unless you converted them to vegetarians. And if you did, I know they pissed off at you. Hope they don't eat you. Oh, and this ain't chicken fried steak, by the way. This is Grillades, like I already told you. That batter ain't thick enough. You gotta put chicken fried steak in a batter. Like a buttermilk seasoned batter. And fry it, but we ain't making that right now. I need to do a chicken fried steak at some point.
Ain't got no buttermilk.
Buttermilk. Now, how you like that, girl?
Now fry them down and get them a little brown. Don't get you all too hot where it starts popping all over. If it starts popping, cut the fob back. You got liquid in that meat. What is that liquid?
What the hell you think it is? What's inside of you? Blood.
And it'll pop, liquid will pop in the oil. Keep your heat on the control. So I'm using a smaller burner. Now I decided just to make little happy faces on my dough. I put them little fat strips back in here. And they also releasing some flavor into this pan. I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do with that. The fat strips make happy faces on your puppy dough. Not sad faces. They love it. See the pan get a little hot. See it popping? Some of them fat strips. Happy, happy doggy. So let's go ahead and matter of fact, I'm gonna cut the fire off. Oh, way down, because I got some more to fry. Go ahead and remove these and put them in a separate container. Actually, the lid of the pot, because we're gonna smother this down. So go on and get all your meat out of there. You see that goodness in the bottom of that pot? Oh, man, that's what's gonna make you brave. Happy, happy, like the dog's fitting to be. Some of it is peeling off of that meat. That's okay, don't worry about that. It'll be okay. With all that going back in there. And that flour and meat jizz. And that's gonna help thicken your gravy up. Whoa, watch yourself, JB. You don't want that on your pants. I hope they zipped up too, boy. Look over here, over here, over here. Go ahead and put them other little strips of fat in there that got a little bit of beef on them. You won't starve your dogs to death, do you? They got no flour on them, though. But they gonna cut the fire back up, camera boy. Pay attention to what you're doing. But they're releasing some of this tallow. And I don't know if y'all know what tallow is. Beef tallow is what McDonald's fries, when they were really good, really, really good, were fried with. 50% tallow, 50% vegetable oil. How about that? Earl, yeah, that's the ticket. So you can render this tallow and beef down and make Earl. We ain't got time for all that in this video. I already did it in another video. Go back and watch it. Tallow French fries, I think I call it. With ground brisket burgers. I bought a big ass brisket and I smoked the flat and I took the prank and ground it down in my meat grinder and made burgers with it. You talk about what's fine. And the fat that I cut off, I made some tallow and fried some fresh, I don't remember what I used. I don't remember whether I cut fresh French fries or I used frozen fries and fried them in that beef tallow and vegetable oil mix. Oh. And the only thing better than that would be to fry them in duck fat. Yum. Or bacon grease.
Yum, a large yum. Let me get another beer.
Alright. Well, let's go ahead and dump with some onions in there. And look, we got us some little puppy dog tails over here. Oh, them dogs will be happy with that. Trust me. So these onions are going to start releasing water and start deglazing the bottom of this pan. And we're going to help them out just a little bit. So let these sit in here for a few minutes. Rough chop these, because you're going to make a gravy. See, that meat's already made of stock. It's going to be a wonderful, wonderful meal. That's how we do it in South Louisiana. If you want to duplicate it, don't be stupid and add something different. Do it like this. We also want to add some more salt. Where my damn pepper? Right there. Now this ain't burned down here no more. Don't think that for 1 second. This is yum down there. So where the wine's at, boy? Go get it and pour it in here. Right now. Get you a wine you drink. Something's got a stopper like that. A cork that you have to pull out of some bitch. Okay? Now start working all that stuff off the bottom of that pan. Don't burl the wine. You can simmer it, but don't burl a piss out of this. See all that's coming off? We don't need no damn Brillo pad or none of that bullshit. Lay your Brillo pad right in that pot. See all that's releasing? I gotta get some other shit in here right now. So let me get done and get that in here. See, we just made us a little, how you call it? I forget what this is called. It's called something in French style cooking. In JB style cooking, it's called that, right there, just off the fire. Now let's go on and make, pour some instant diet water, just plain low fat diet water in there. And I washed one of them green fruits called a bell pepper. If you don't think that's a fruit, then you a fruit. It is a fruit. Why? I'll show you why in a minute. I gotta get this going. See that brown gravy? We ain't put no coloring in that. The coloring is from frying that stuff down in the bottom. Just like that. We got to put some more fruit in there. That kind of fruit. Use the stew, too.
I just massacred a couple toes of garlic. Some little small toes right here. Look. Whack them up a little better, JB. Go pour them in that meat gravy. Okay, gonna do it too.
Okay, the garlic's in there. Now let's get some of this Lee and Panties
what's this here sauce? And put some in there. You want hot sauce, you put that in there too. Make this hot or cold as you want it. It's gonna be real fine once all this cooks down. I'm gonna let these vegetables smother just a little bit longer. And I'm gonna sample some of that meat that's sitting over here calling my name. Oh, y'all. Tough as hell. After it simmers in that sauce, it's gonna get tender, tender, tender. We're gonna let it simmer in there for about 2 hours. If I can wait that long. Yeah, a little bit has passed.
It had about 5 minutes.
Let's put our meat in there. Get it down all amongst everything that you see. And we'll come back to this. You're gonna have to whir it every now and then. You may have to add some more liquid. Don't know yet. Yeah, I do too know. I know we are. Man, I want another piece. I should not put it all in there. We just have to wait till dinner time. Meanwhile, we go find a dog and let them sample on them little tails back there. See over there, boy. Need a faster zoom on this son of a bitch over there. All right. I'm gonna change your little batteries and diaper and everything too. So we got some of these red taters, and we're gonna wash them, give them a little bath, and slice them up and smother them down. Bad. So we're gonna saute down some onion in a pan.
With one whole onion.
Get that cooking. Just like that. Look, you left some peeling on it, JB. Tighten up. Just eat it. It's fiber. Don't worry about it. Put some pepper. Put some salt. Put a little Cajun seasoning in that too, just for fun. It's not too much. And sweat that down. Okay, now we got all these onions sweated down. Let's take them out of there. And I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. I done removed the onions and slice up some taters. I left the skins on them. And we're gonna fry these down somewhat in some oil. Should have probably most likely been sliced a little thinner than what I've done. Miss JB was gonna help me, but I pissed her off and she's mad now. So I just have to do the best I can. I run out the damn kitchen is what I've done now. While the camera's still up and running, look, here's one of them pieces of round steak. Look right here. Yeah, I just pull right apart like that with my finger. See like that? That's how we cook down the bayou. A boy. So we're gonna go on and layer all these taters in here. Thick cut, thin cut, it don't matter. Chuck them on there and put a lid on the pot let them smother down for a little bit. Oh, you know what I forgot? We gotta put some seasoning on them. Oh, hell yeah. They love salt. Cut, camera boy. Start recording, camera boy. So put you some salt on. Put you some pepper on them. Add them onions back in there. Alright, so you keep stirring your taters around till they're all nice and brown like that. And I got some spinach right down there. And fresh out the damn can. And there's them griots. So you serve that just like Miss JB finna do.
She made grits with that.
We ain't had no grits, you ate them all.
We got grits.
Oh, we do? Okay.
Oh my God, there's lots of garlic.
Yeah. Supposed to be like that.
You know, you can eat this with rice.
And grits. And potatoes. And you can fry an egg and put it on top of this. And or on scrambled eggs, as Miss JB just mentioned. How about that shit? Yum. Now we need to make some biscuits. Miss JB didn't make none. But I'm fitting
you
to make some.
Leave the kitchen.
Leave the kitchen. Here we go. I'm gonna make some biscuits.
You should make the biscuits already.
Well, you just go ahead and eat. You don't get no biscuits. I ain't making none. How about that, Unity?
I'm not gonna comment.
So now we got us some biscuits here. And these are fresh. That I just baked. How you like that? We'll put us some butter and honey on them. Yeah. Get you some of this. So how tender is this meat? Watch here. Let me show you something. Look right down here. Just a old spoon. See how I just mash apart like that? Look. See? So, go play on your damn seesaw, boy. Now. Okay, we gotta get us some taters on there. See how they look in there? See right there? And you gotta scrape them off the bottom. Because that bottom burnt part that you think is burnt, ain't burnt. This is most wonderful southern meal right here. With all them onions and salts and peppers. Put them right there on your plate. And eat all of this. Yum. What you thought that was, a raisin? No, boy. That's flavor. Give me some more of them. Yeah. Yum. Eat.